lot for the introduction. So my name is Mario. I'm one of the engineers, software engineers of the Beyla team at Grafana. And I will explain today briefly what's Beyla all about and how to use it to instrument your running services without extra configuration or redeployments from your side. This is a short talk. There will be no questions, but after the talk, you can find me at the Grafana booth. So come, say hello, and ask whenever you, whatever you want. What do we mean by auto-instrumentation? Let me just put some context. Auto-instrumentation already existed before Beyla, of course, and it was based mostly on injecting an agent between your application and its runtime. For example, the Java Virtual Machine or .NET or any other runtime. Those runtimes usually provide mechanisms to inject there an agent that is able to listen for some events, intercept them, and then, for example, provide or export metrics and traces. Beyla is not here to change that. So if that works for you, keep using it, because they usually work like a charm, namely the OpenTelemetry agents or the Grafana language agents. They work pretty well. But there are some cases that you could have some problems with auto-instrumentation. I don't know why this is now it's okay. So what happens with auto-instrumentation, for example, if your runtime is too old, if you are using an old Java virtual machine or from a given implementation of the Java virtual machine that does not support most of the modern language agents? Or what happens if your runtime is in an interpreted language and the instrumentation is written in this, the instrumentation agent is written in this language agent and adds some overhead to your service? Or even if you cannot auto-instrument, you cannot inject any agent because your application is a compiled binary, a Go binary, a Rust binary. In that case, you could instrument it manually, inserting the probes into your code, but you need to redeploy your code. Maybe you don't have the resources, or maybe the code is legacy and nobody wants to touch it. To cover those cases, Beyla uses eBPF. eBPF is a virtual machine that modern Linux kernels provide that allows you injecting some bytecode that is compiled just in time and allows you attaching programs efficiently at your application runtime or at the kernel runtime. It allows you pipping the memory of your runtimes, applications, and modify or just read it to get insights about what's going on. So Beyla uses eBPF, is deployed as a privileged process in your host, and without having to reconfigure or redeploy anything from your applications, Beyla attaches to some eBPF hooks to provide metrics and traces about your application, mostly focused on web application. Beyla then exports this information as metrics or traces via standard endpoints like OpenTelemetry endpoints, Prometheus, or even you can send the data directly to Grafana Cloud. So Beyla is vendor neutral. What metrics provide Beyla? The language that is with the most complete support is Go currently. With Beyla, you can instrument your web applications and get out of the box HTTP, HTTPS, HTTP2, and gRPC metrics. More protocols will be supported in the future. We need to clearly enumerate what we support because many people might think that eBPF is like magic. You put everything there, say, hey, tell me everything, and eBPF returns you the information. But with eBPF, you need to work at the binary level. So adding new protocols mean knowing how those protocols are organized at the binary level, how a given language is also organized at the binary level so you can read their variables at runtime. So protocols need to be added one by one. For Go, Beyla hooks into the Go libraries and runtime, but Beyla is also able to hook and listen to some kernel libraries. That way, it's able to provide also basic metrics for almost any other language. For example, it's able to provide HTTP and HTTPS metrics, HTTP for virtually any language that can run in Linux, and HTTPS for any language but Java. Java brings its own TLS library, which is compiled at the Java bytecode. It's much more complex. We are also able to provide traces. For Go applications, Beyla provides fully distributed tracing. That means context propagation. So you can see your traces, how they are related with other traces for all the protocols we already mentioned, HTTP, HTTP2, and gRPC. And for the rest of programming languages, at the moment, it's able to provide single spans or partial support for distributed tracing only if the processes with the same context are in the same host. This difficulty comes because Beyla, for providing distributed tracing, Beyla needs to not only read your HTTP information, but being able also to modify it, modify your headers. And that comes with a lot of security restrictions and support. That's why in the rest of programming languages is still limited. I will do a quick demo just to show how Beyla works. I deployed a distributed application based is all the application is written in Go. We have a load generator that sends data to a frontend. The frontend sends data to a backend, and that backend distributes the load across workers. And Beyla, one of the points we focused on Beyla was try, even if it's highly configurable, try to let Beyla run with minimal configuration, and with minimal configuration have something working. So Beyla just needs two configuration options. One is some coordinates, some indications about where to instrument, what application to instrument. You could say Beyla instrument all the process in your host, in a given host, but maybe you don't want that and you want only to instrument a subset, automatically instrument a subset of applications because the other applications might be already instrumented. So in this example, Beyla can run in any host, physical, or it doesn't require Kubernetes to run. It can run in bare metal. But in this example, oh, it's OK. In this example, we are providing a YAML configuration telling Beyla, in the demo it's deployed in Kubernetes, this simple configuration we're telling Beyla instrument all the applications that are either in the demo namespace or either in the it's block namespace. It's just namespaces in the example. So Beyla will look for all the processes running or all the processes belonging to pods running in such namespace. With that should work, but you can also provide extra configuration in order to have a richer experience. So you can, for example, tell Beyla to get the HTTP routes, the routes of your HTTP or gRPC service, and to avoid having a cardinality explosion, grouping those routes heuristically. That will mean that, for example, it will try to identify any user ID or any ID, some gibberish words into your routes and group them as IDs in order to all the routes having a the same pattern be grouped as the same route. You can also provide manually your own routes so you make sure it will capture the routes as you want. And we will tell to, for example, also decorate the metrics and traces with Kubernetes attributes. The other mandatory configuration option of Beyla is tell Beyla how to export the information. You can tell Beyla, okay, just open a Prometheus port, or in that case, send this data. I don't know why this. Okay, send this data to the open telemetry endpoint. Here we just provide two standard open telemetry configuration variables to point to Grafana Cloud with some secret that obviously we are not sharing here. And then Beyla will out of the box send the data to Grafana as queries and or as metrics and or traces. Here in this example, you can see a dashboard we already provide. It's free to download. It's freely available, in which you can see some basic metrics information about your applications, like slowest, HTTP routes, or methods. Can you see this factorial asterisk? This factorial was followed by a number that could vary depending on the invocation, and Beyla automatically has grouped it as an asterisk. And there you can see all your applications, the backend, the frontend. This load gen is empty because it simply doesn't have inbound traffic. So you can see the inbound traffic of your services and the outbound traffic. Beyla also works with other parts of Grafana Cloud, like the application, our application observability. You can see here all the services, how they are partially integrated. Not all the parts work, but you can also see here the traces and how the traces are distributed. You see here the backend, the worker. So every trace that Beyla has captured propagates the context of the caller and the callee. And even you can see also the service map of the front end, the back end, and so on. So that's all about I wanted to share with you. So what are the future plans of Beyla? On one side, we want to support more protocols like SQL, message queues. That will depend, this SQL will depend on the different bunch of SQL libraries, message queue protocols, and so on. We would like to extend and improve and provide distributed tracing, so you can get distributed traces for more languages and in more context, not only for Go. And the last version of Beyla also provides experimental support for L2, L3, and L4 metrics. So in your cluster, you will be able to see from two endpoints how many bytes, and all this information being decorated with metadata like hosts, Kubernetes metadata, and so on. Thank you for your attention. As I said before, you can find me outside if you have any question or any comment. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.